Back on Fox Business to talk about what may be some fuzzy math coming out of Washington. At least that's what Joe DiGuardi thinks. He's a Republican candidate for the U.S. Senate out of New York, running against Kirsten Gillibrand. He's here to explain why he thinks our nation's balance sheet's trillions of dollars more than Washington is letting on. Joe, good to see you. Thank you for coming in.
Thank you for inviting me, Colin.
You think that the debt situation, which we all know is bad, is even worse. Tell us why and how bad it is.
Much worse. The government, the United States of America, doesn't use the accounting system that the Securities and Exchange Commission imposes on publicly traded corporations to protect shareholders. The budget process uses a Mickey Mouse cash basis of accounting, just like you would use on your check register.
You're an accountant, a CPA. You also remember Congress back in the 80s. But let's bring up one of the screens here. We'll talk about what Joe thinks is the fuzzy math. Then I can go through some of the numbers here. Publicly held debt, $7 trillion plus. The federal liability, Social Security and Medicare, $4.4 trillion. Federal employees and the benefits program for the veterans, $5.25 trillion, and see some of the other numbers there. Let's just say you're right about all of this, that the real numbers are worse than they're being reported.
Okay.
You're elected as a senator in a hypothetical. What do you do about it? That's the real question.
How do you tell the truth to the American people that we have spent more money than they think?
Yeah, but say
these things have to be paid.
All that's fine. Now what?
All right. Well, now what? How about not raising the debt limit next time, $1.9 trillion like Gillibrand just did? In fact, she's been there 2 years. She's raised it twice.
You want to shut down the government?
No, but I would, on a point of personal privilege, come on the Senate floor and say, wait a minute, we're not going to raise it that much. We're going to bring this bill up every month. If you want $100 billion this month, tell the people what you want to spend it on. Bring the OMB director on, CBO office on, and share the pain of the American people. This is not just accounting, Connell. This is the American dream going down the toilet. This is showing that the United States of America is fiscally unsustainable, and we're going towards bankruptcy.
You're running as a Republican in New York State, the heavily Democratic state, but Republicans are doing very well in this election cycle. We know all that.
They're energized.
What's
coming out?
Right. Are you a Tea Party guy? You identify with?
I will accept every invitation.
No, but are you a
Tea Party? Well, basically, I feel their anger.
Right.
Why do you think it exists? It's not a structured party. It's a vehicle for those that are really disaffected, disenchanted, to show their anger about Albany and Washington.
So a Tea Party guy can win in New York? I mean, Palladino's running that way for governor. Who knows how he'll do? You're running that way for Senate. I looked at some of the polls. Depends which poll it is. Some of them are actually pretty close between you and Senator Gillibrand.
And they're going to get closer.
Margin,
they're going to get closer.
One of the polls, which is very close.
Yeah, it's not just Tea Party. You know, it's the Republicans, conservatives, independents. They feel angry, too. And I think you're going to see a political revolution come.
But is it just about the spending? For example, on some of the social issues, are you out there on the social issues?
Of course, but you forgot the main issue. And this ties into it. Jobs.
Yeah.
I mean, we have 1 million people out of work in New York State, 15 million people in America. New York State is at probably the top of the list as a place that pushes people away. And why?
Okay.
Our tax rate in New York overall is 70% higher than the national average. It shows you how toxic this environment is. Hey, vote for me. Get my website.
That's a major case, definitely.
DiGuardi2010.com.
You're running again as a I don't want to say a Tea Party candidate, but you say you identify with their values. You're running as a Republican in New York.
Conservative Republican.
Real quick, conservative Republican. Where are you on social issues? You
conservative.
On abortion and everything else across the board.
Yes.
And you think you can win in New York that way?
Absolutely.
We'll see, I guess, how the polls run out. And
Back in 84. Four Democrats were Republican in my district. I engaged the people. I'm the son of immigrants.
This is statewide.
Product of the American dream. I pass it on to Kara. We got to preserve that dream.
How's Kara doing, by the way, now that she left Idol, your daughter?
She's doing
hanging in there?
She was doing fine before. She's doing fine now.
Good to see you, Joe.
Let her solve Hollywood while I solve Washington.
While you solve Washington. All right. We should point out we asked Senator Gillibrand to come on, and hopefully we'll have her on to discuss her side of the issues as she goes against Joe DiGuardi in running for the Senate in New
York.
Don't
forget, DiGuardi2010.com.
We know. You can buy a commercial on the station, too, as we can use it.